डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अवर थर्ड चैप्टर एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट सोशल एंड कल्चरल इफेक्ट्स। एंड इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी लर्न अबाउट द न्यू इंडस्ट्रीज इन इंडिया एंड इन इट वी लर्न अबाउट जमशेदजी टाटा, अबाउट द नाना भाई दवर, कवरजी नाना भाई दवर टेक्सटाइल मिल एंड सो ऑन। Now in today's video we will learn about the social and cultural effect. In the 19th century, Europe, a new era took shape on basis of values like humanitarianism, democracy, nationalism and liberalism. Now see, in the 19th century, at the very beginning of the 19th century in Europe, a new era took place on the basis of the values like humanitarianism means we have to behave with one another like a human. We have to help them, we have to cooperate them, and we should behave with one another like a human, not like a animal. And second, democracy. Now many of the countries in Europe, they are accepting the democracy system. Nationalism, the peoples, they proud for their country and they were trying their best to give the respect to the nation, that is nationalism. And liberalism means instead of fighting, instead of revolution, we should administer our region with the laws. They are giving the preference to the laws instead of revolution. Whatever their demands are there, whatever they need, they were trying to achieve it with the help of laws instead of revolution, instead of violence. It is liberalism. These values took place in the 19th century in Europe and it is known as a new era took place. These changes in the West led to obvious repercussion. Repercussion means very clearly, very important, and it repercussion on India and the effects of these values that also seen very clearly, obvious means very clearly in on Indian polity also, on India also, the values like humanitarianism, democracy, nationalism and liberalism, this took place, took shape in 19th century in Europe. But it also, the effects or the reflection of these values can be seen on Indian polity. For carrying out administration, the British had to understand the Indian society. For this purpose, they started studying the Indian polity or tradition, history, literature, as well as music, flora, fauna of India. See now, to run the smooth administration of our country, Britishers, now they need to study about the tradition of Indian people, about the literature, about the music and about the flora and fauna, means the varieties in plants and animal, that is flora and fauna. And in the year 1784, Sir William Jones, an English officer, established the Asiatic Society of Bengal at Kolkata. Right, it is important for us in the year 1784 to study the tradition, history, literature, music, flora and fauna. The English officer William Jones, he established the Asiatic Society of Bengal at Kolkata. Right, now next, Max Müller, a German thinker, was a great devout scholar of Indian religion, language and history. Sir William Jones, an English officer, he did a great work. He established Asiatic Society of Bengal at Kolkata. Then this person, German thinker, who is this Max Müller, he was also a great devout or scholar of Indian religion, language and history. Due to these examples, there arose feeling among newly educated Indians to study Indian religion, history and tradition. And because of these peoples, many of the new or they were are used feeling means they are now ready to study our own tradition, Indian study, among their aroused feeling among newly educated Indians to study about the Indian religion, history and tradition. Now the young and scholar person of India, they were also trying to study about the Indian religion, history and tradition. Now the British introduced many laws in India. In 1829, Lord William Bentinck passed the Sati Prohibition Act. Now here Sati Prohibition Act, it is very important. This person, Lord William Bentinck, a British officer, passed the Sati Prohibition Act. Sati Prohibition Act means if the woman's husband died, the wife has to sacrifice his life. Though she is young, though she is old, then also she has to jump in the fire of her husband. That is Sati Prohibition. It is very unhuman. It is very unhuman because other people, they are forcing her to jump. Or they are throwing her in the husband's fire. Or that is known as Sati. Sati means if husband died, the wife has to sacrifice her life, though she is of any age. It is known as Sati. And this unhuman tradition was there in India. And Lord William Bentinck, in the year 1829, he passed the Sati Prohibition Act.